Moons of Madness, developed by Rock Pocket and Dream Loop Games and distributed by Funcom, and coming out in Halloween 2019. But have you even heard about this game? This is Pablo with BND Gaming, and I'll tell you what's going on. With E3 just passes and PAX right around the corner, nobody's talking about that game. The only mention on E3 about this game was an interview that only had 184 views on YouTube. So the only reason why I found out about this game was because someone on my feed actually mentioned it. And with the game release date of 90 days from the day of this video, there gotta be something wrong. So after doing a lot of research on the internet, the only information I found in all websites, I mean the field they're actually covering this game, was the same PR information you can get in Funcom and Rock Pocket Games websites, and a 12-minute gameplay video that was released by the same. So I did find out on PC Gamer that 2 years ago there was a demo going around that had been tested, but that was all that was about it. But in the 2 years that this demo came out, a lot of changes happened in the game. And basically one of them was, since Funcom got on to publish the game, they decide to actually make some changes on the game to put Moons of Madness in the same world as the Secret World Legends. What for me just feels like a way for Funcom to capitalize on the possible success of this game. And while I have great trust on Rock Pocket Games because of their former releases, Funcom as the publisher does worry me a little bit, because they have lost a lot of trust from the community because of a lot of microtransactions and also coming up with games that are not fully complete and just fix games after a release. So yeah, I do worry that Funcom, that is distributing the game, may be meddling more than they should in the actual game. And that's something you see a lot in Hollywood, like for example Spider-Man 3, that could have been a success, but got pretty much destroyed by meddling from the producers. Now, by the trailer and the gameplay, this game looks beautiful. It looks like a mix of Silent Hill, Dead Space, The Martian, and Lovecraft. What, for me, it's pretty awesome. But you see, that raised another concern. I mean, a game that looks so amazing and haven't been talked about and had no demos being sent out to be tested does worry me. I mean, I can't tell if maybe because of the meddling the game's not finished and they're just going with Halloween 2019 with hopes that they're gonna be able to finish and patch all the issues on time, or two, the game is not that amazing and it's really slow paced and people gonna hate, so they're just afraid to show people prior to release, hoping that people gonna buy to try. I mean, I even went to the streets and asked people that working in gaming stores, and none of them had heard about the game. And the only information they found on websites was the 12-minute video and the trailer. I mean, all the magazines that cover new releases, they have not mentioned the game at all. They were talking about all the releases up to 2020. I tried to find information on Reddit and post on r/sreddit if anybody had even heard about the game, and I got no answers. I actually got a downvote for even asking that. I emailed Rock Pocket Games to try to find out some information of why nobody has been talking about and no demos have been sent out, and I got really no answer. And the only thing I found out is their link to get in touch with them, well, it doesn't work. So I had to send a direct email to be able to try to talk to them. Now, why I don't worry so much about Funcom, I do worry about Rock Pocket Games. I mean, they're not the biggest company. But you know, I do love when the little guy actually comes out with a great title, because that forces bigger companies, like EA for example, to come out with great titles, because the small guy coming out with a better title than yours, that makes you innovate. And that's what drives the market. Big companies sometimes just come out with really bad titles because that's your only option. So a small company comes out with an amazing game, like Moons of Madness could be, that will force every other company to actually step up their game. So guys, I don't really know, is that game going to be a win or a bust? I would love to hear from you guys how you feel about this game. I'm gonna keep playing the gameplay until the end of the video. Leave me in the comments how you feel, what you think about Funcom being the distributor for the game, how your feelings about the game, what you think about the gameplay. Just let me know in the comments. Don't forget to give me a like, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notifications bell. I hope you guys have a great end of the week, and I'll be seeing you guys in the weekend. Have a great day. Take care.
And you know what that means.
Sleeping in?
Boring Martian routine, which is a lot like boring Earthling routine, but if you don't do it, you die.
Hey, what's up with the lights?
Security malfunction, I think. System's all bugaboo. Doors are locking according to a glitched security protocol. And from the looks of it, our batteries are not recharging to optimal levels. Solar panels are probably caked with dust. We'll have to do an EVA to clean them. And by we, I mean you.
In for a penny, in for a pound. Any news, Orson?
I'm still working on the doors. In the meantime, why don't you get in some exercise on the treadmill? You could use it. Hey, Shane? Remember to log your activities in the bio gauge.
Copy that. Crap.
What's up?
I seem to have misplaced my bio gauge.
Oh, sweet, foolish Shane. I swear you'd lose your arm if the Greys, the Reptilians, and I didn't surgically reattach it every night as you sleep. I think I saw a bio gauge in the lab. Better get it before you do anything else. Speaking of which, that should do it. I fixed the lounge door to the lab.
Okay.
You all right? You don't sound too good.
It's nothing. It's just another migraine. It'll pass.
Okay, serious question time. When you get Earthside, are you going to ask Manticore for a raise?
Think I should?
If you don't ask, you'll never get it.
You think if I ask, they'll give it to me?
No.
Is that bio gauge? No good. I think there's a reset button somewhere. Just my luck. I need to find something that can fit in there. Orson, I found the bio gauge, but it won't turn on. I need to reset it.
Find something small and thin. A pen should work.
There. Got it working.
Great. You should be able to reboot the security system now. Just scan the servers with the biogauge.
Nothing ever seems to work right there. Orson, I'm going to check on the greenhouse. Is a mess. There's severe flooding and a weird mist. That can't be normal.
Mm-hmm. Volkova.
What?
The head botanist. Real mad science vibe. Who knows what she's been up to. Anyway, go check on the water reclaimer. I'm reading it is offline.
Orson!